Hey guys, it's Aaron Farmer with MySugarFreeJourney.com, and a new issue, I guess you could call it, has come across my desk today. I thought it was interesting enough to share with you. Are Ziploc bags causing dementia? So there's a new class action lawsuit that has been filed in California that is accusing SC Johnson, the makers of Ziploc bags, of labeling their bags as microwave and freezer safe while knowing that these bags leach large amounts of microplastics into food at extreme temperatures. So if you're putting your food in Ziploc bags and you're microwaving it, or you are throwing it in the freezer, which you're supposed to be able to do because they're labeled as microwave safe and freezer bags, that they're dumping so many microplastics into our food that it's causing issues. So I did a little research. Most of the stuff you probably know already, but there's no definitive proof that microplastics cause any harm, which I thought was interesting, because it's one of those issues that's just hard to study. While it's difficult, I guess, to prove causation, there's a high degree of correlation. Some research has shown that higher percentage of microplastics are in the brains of those with dementia. And so it isn't clear, really, if microplastics are causing the dementia, or if there's something about the process that causes dementia that allows more microplastics into the brain. So perhaps if you have a brain that, for whatever genetic reason, allows more plastics into the brain, you're more prone to get dementia. Or maybe the microplastics are causing dementia. Who knows? I mean, it's one of those things that's really difficult at this point to study. So, you know, whichever. We also know that at least in animal models, that microplastics can cross the blood-brain barrier. We know that microplastics in the brain cause oxidative stress and inflammation, and we know that both oxidative stress and inflammation in the brain have been linked to dementia. So, you know, it's one of these things where there's a lot of smoke. We don't have the definitive science yet that says microplastics are causing dementia, but there's a lot of smoke here. So it would probably be smart if you stayed away from things that increase the amount of microplastics that you took in. So do Ziplocs add microplastics to our food? Well, that's kind of the question that is exactly what this class action suit is going to try to figure out. It specifically wants to know if the products that were labeled microwave and freezer safe leach an increased amount of microplastics into food when used in the freezer or in the microwave. And so we might know an answer to this. Now, it'll probably take years, you know, if it even goes to trial. But, you know, if it doesn't get thrown out, or, you know, something fishy doesn't happen, it'll probably take years for this suit to get through the system. It may take a decade or more. But until then, I'll be keeping an eye on this. I'd like to let you know, as this thing increases, because I think microplastics in food is one of those issues. I don't think it's the most important issue. I think the most important health issue that we need to face today is insulin resistance. That, you know, insulin resistance is the number one problem that we need to solve in, you know, with our food system. But microplastics might be a solid number two. I can tell you that we've switched over to mostly glass bowls to store our food in. Glass bowls are relatively cheap. You can get them on Amazon for not a whole lot. They're a one-time buy. You buy them once and you can continue to reuse them over and over and over again. I have one set of plastic Tupperware that I use when I go to work, because I don't want to leave the house with the glass, because I don't want to break anything. But other than that, you know, we pretty much keep everything in glass, and we don't heat anything up in plastic. We don't freeze anything in plastic. So it's, you know, it's possible for you to do that. In fact, we really don't freeze anything. the only thing we freeze is meat nowadays, and we wrap that in paper. So I thought you guys might be interested in this. You can come over to my site, mysugarfreejourney.com, to get more information. Otherwise, we'll talk to you later. Goodbye.